Hi, I'm Lance from South Louisiana. I've recently changed my voters' registration from Republican to Democrat to combat having to vote for Trump again. Now we only have a choice between Biden and Trump, so I have to kind of weigh the pros and cons between them. I would love to vote third party, but there's just too many older voters who do not understand most of the third party standings. Republicans would most likely side with Libertarian if they actually had a choice, but that's just not an option. I don't think there's going to be the votes that are required. You could actually look back at Ron Paul. He was mostly Libertarian, and people knew that about him. And he didn't get a lot of support from the media, not a lot of showtime. They tried their best to make sure voters did go for him. So I don't think third party is really an option. So we're going to have to weigh those options in. There's a good reason why I don't like Trump. He has a lot of promises that he made before he ran and while he was running. And you could look at his story now. He always talked about spending overseas with military and conflicts in the Middle East. He said that he was going to cut spending, and now he's starting to go back. You could watch the numbers, and it's starting to climb kind of up to par with Obama's numbers. So there's that. I'll hit where I started with, which would be the wall. He started with, oh, Mexico's going to pay for the wall. We all knew that wasn't going to happen. When it didn't happen, he still somehow got a lot of support for it. But when you think about it, that's a whole lot of money. And it's not just building it that people need to look at. You got to look at the future. So when it comes to actually funding it, there's going to be maintenance. There's still going to be a bunch of border patrol that surrounds it. So there's no cutting in spending there. There's going to be a lot of spending, and it's going to be spending that my kids have to pay in taxes as well in the future. So we're going to have to really think about that when it comes to reelecting him. I really don't know who I'm going to vote for, but I just cannot support Trump for a lot of the reasons I've listed, and he's already shown that he doesn't care about ending conflict. There's still sanctions, and sanctions only hurt the people in the country. It does not hurt the wealthy and the leaders of that country. So you're just making people suffer. You're making kids starve. You're making their economy tremble, and the leaders aren't going to suffer. They're going to make their people suffer. There's not going to be a revolution either. So let's also talk about the fact that he's kind of flip-flopped a lot. He said that the Electoral College was bad, which I do believe the Electoral College is bad. There should be more of a popular vote, but Republicans are always going to support that. And I understand the support for it, but you got to think majority vote, I think, is still the best option when it comes to electing someone. I also want to talk about how his defense budget, it's like the largest ever. So how are you going to cut spending when you want to spend all this money on defense? We could cut a lot of that spending and get rid of these bases in the Middle East and actually worry about our own country. We could keep our joint operations in Europe. It's okay to have these bases out, but you really need to keep neutrality, and you're not keeping neutrality by keeping our military forces in countries where they don't want us. That just causes conflict. It causes hatred towards us. Surrounding Iran with bases, that's an act of war. I don't see how NATO approves of it. It's just that it's way over the top. It's more money we have to spend that we don't need to spend. If Trump was really about cutting spending, he wouldn't have this much adding to the deficit. With his new plan coming with the next election, if he wins, I think he's going to end up spending more or the same amount as Obama. So you can't really combat with lies like that. And I wouldn't like, I hate throwing around that word, oh, he's a liar, but you have to look at his past of everything he said before and look at what he's doing now. It just doesn't line up to why people voted for him, but he still panders to his voters and he grabs the attention of them. I think people are voting for him just because of what he says and how he talks about his political career, but he is not really delivering. So now we have the option between both Biden and Trump. We're going to see what happens. I'm still weighing my options, but I do not support them.